Chan is a stylish Irishman, and I'm a stylish Irishman. So the mother tells me. Stylish Irish fan, welcome back to the channel. To all my new subscribers, thank you for subscribing. And to anyone who might be clicking into this video who's not subscribed, invite you to stick around, see what you think. And if you're interested in content like this, hit the subscribe button and hit the bell so you're notified of future uploads. And please give this video a like, it really helps with engagement on the channel. So on to the topic of conversation today, which is Acqua Di Parma, Fico Di Amalfi. So if that's what you're interested in seeing, stick around for the intro and we'll get into it. Welcome to Stylish Irish Fan. Welcome to my channel. And this here is my favourite summer fragrance now at the moment. It's a new acquisition of mine. So just have a quick look at the presentation now. I actually had to stop recording there for about 20 minutes. Two fellas right outside my window haggling over the price of a car. They were fair loud. Anyway, let's take a look at the presentation. So this was released in 2006. As a fruity floral fragrance for women, actually. It's definitely unisex though. And it actually gets a vote of 4.33 out of 5 with over 1300 votes on Fragrantica. So that says a lot about it. It's very highly rated fragrance as a whole. Has a lovely bottle. Very summery. So guys, the top notes here are lemon, bergamot, grapefruit and citron. Very citrusy opening. So I'm just gonna spray the opening on my skin now. So I have to dry down in this hand. So it opens up very citrusy. You don't get much fig from the opening, but the citrusy top soon wears off and gives you, you soon get into the middle then where the fig comes in. The fig is the main player here along with the grapefruit. And they both combine to give this a somewhat peachy scent. So it's really pleasant. I can see why it would be marketed to women, but men can definitely pull it off. I pull it off. It's really nice, fresh, and it has somewhat of a transparent quality to it as well. You won't even feel like there's a fragrance, that it actually is a fragrance on you. It's that pleasant. It actually has somewhat of a cooling quality about it as well. So when I spray it on, sometimes it just makes me feel cool in the hot summer heat. It's a weird effect that some fragrances do have. I think that this definitely is one with that quality. So the projection and sillage here also is very moderate. Maybe 1 foot, 2 foot max projection and a small sillage as well. Smells very pleasing, stays close enough to the skin though. But that's what you want with a summer fragrance. You don't want to be hitting people in the face with your fragrance. So with the fig in the mid, the wood comes in at the base slightly. So it gives you this kind of peachy vibe, but it's a fig scent with some bergamot and a base of some cedar. Overall though, guys, I think this is a very good pick for summer. It's my first one of the Blue Mediterranean line to try, and I'd highly recommend it. It's an affordable niche fragrance also. So this is a 150ml bottle. I actually mentioned in my top 10 summer list that this was 180ml. Don't know why I thought it was, but it's a 150ml bottle, which I got for €116, I think. So that's not a bad price for a niche perfume, especially for 150ml. It's not so, like, you wouldn't get Chanel, Bleu de Chanel for that price. 150ml of Bleu de Chanel probably costs €130. So for a niche fragrance, it's a good price. Very pleasing, not going to offend anyone. Has a cooling quality and is very unique. This is a unique scent note that I have never smelt anything like before. So I'd really recommend giving this one a try. I'd give this a rate now, 5 out of 5, perfect for summer. Has the good performance. It has good longevity also, actually, forgot to mention. The longevity on this is definitely at least 8 hours on my skin. Might not perform as well in other aspects, like the projection and sillage, but it's exactly what I want a fragrance to be in summer. So you could definitely wear this even in a situation where a fragrance isn't allowed, because it actually doesn't even feel like a fragrance as such. It's so pleasant and transparent, in my opinion. So guys, check out Fico Di Amalfi. I highly recommend it. So guys, that's my take on Fico Di Amalfi. One of my favorite summer fragrances, and it still has to be topped now, this one. This is my number one fragrance at the moment for summer. And it's going to take something special to take its place. Really like this one. Going to be wearing it a lot. I've already put a good dent in it and only have it a few weeks. So that's everything for this video, guys. Take it handy and God bless.